Down below, they will be united here. Rangers fans and Flyers fans will be standing because of the anthem. Mandated by NHL policy, but very unnecessary since the end of World War II. And we're already hearing chants of USA.
Please rise here to perform O Canada from Toronto, four-time Grammy nominee, Melanie Fiona.
O Canada, our home and native land, true. The true north, strong and free, from far and wide, oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glory.
Presenting today's colors are the men and women from the Pennsylvania Air and Army National Guard, Joint Color Guard. Please remain standing for the U.S. National Anthem. Here to honor America with the singing of our National Anthem, two-time Grammy Award winner, and winner of BET, NAACP, and many other performing awards, Philadelphia native, the legendary Patti LaBelle.
Broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. Still there. Oh.
colorful anthems, two F-18s, two sets of alumni. Proud to watch this, Rod Gilbert and Adam Graves and Mike Richter from the New York Rangers of the past. Hockey is an international game. The New York Rangers have 20 North Americans, 7 Europeans, including goalie Henrik Lundqvist, 29, from Sweden, the gold medal goalie in the Torino Olympics of 06. He's hot. 4 straight wins. Just as hot for Philadelphia, a team with 19 North Americans and 8 Europeans, including Russian-born 23-year-old Sergei Bobrovsky. He has won 5 of his last 6. As you said once in 2010 in Vancouver, thus far, this has been outstandingly outstanding, Mr. Olczyk.
Tremendously tremendous, Doc.
Kimmo Tiimonen and Braden Coburn will start on defense for Philadelphia. That huge line of Scott Hartnell, Claude Giroux, Jaromir Jagr up front. Ryan Callahan and Carl Hagelund flank Brad Richards. Ryan McDonough and Dan Girardi will start as defensemen. But we apparently have some issue to deal with in the ice. Perhaps it is some fragments from some of the pyrotechnics that have gone on here too. That could very easily be it.
Yeah, there's been some situation right outside the defensive zone for the New York Rangers, standing right in front of Ryan McDonough, 27 for the New York Rangers. There's been some issue on the ice. There's a lot of maintenance there. Some freeze on the ice to make sure that there are no holes in the player safety first and foremost for the National Hockey League, to make sure that this game goes off without a hitch. There's going to be some ice issues, we understand that, but that is it all a part of the event.
Ian Walsh, Dennis LaRue, Jean Morin, Pierre Rassico are the men in stripes for this one today. Kimmo Tiimonen to make the first play. Kick behind, and Ryan Callahan stepped into by Tiimonen, and here's Callahan shooting. Oh, and he hit the post with that shot. A rising shot from a bad angle where he often will score.
And that's where you have to go on Sergei Bobrovsky. A lot of his saves that he makes, except for that one, he's on his knees. So you think about patience and elevation. Nice play there by Callahan right off the bat.
Here comes Claude Giroux weaving his way in, number 2 scorer in the league, through that one that bounced loose to the corner where the Rangers can play. Flipped on back, and it's Giroux up with it. Tried to jam it across. It's poked away by the defense and settled down by Matt Carl back in the neutral zone. Twisted right back to Carl. One-time Hobie Baker Award winner for being the best college player in the United States. Rattled back up the boards and tipped out by high-scoring Marian Gaborik for the Rangers. How does the pace look to you so far?
It's pretty sharp, and I think the one thing that both these teams have talked about, Doc, is that when you get into this environment, you try to get a little too cute, a little bit too pretty. I think it's got to be old-fashioned meat and potatoes. Don't be afraid to get pucks to the net and get people there.
Brought back across and held there for a pass that is deflected away. They battle for it in the corner, and trying to dig it out was Wayne Simmonds, taken along, though, by Matt Reed out of Bemidji State. Jammed on out to center where it can be brought on by the Rangers now, and flung across for a quick shot by Michael Delzotto. That would not go. Jammed to the front by Artem Anisimov and played by Simmonds. Worked over by Gaborik. Poked away from Gaborik. Hustling after it and playing it along further was Mazaros. Flyers able to get as far as center, but very quickly it's brought right back along, and doing a good job of circling there and dropping it back along was John Mitchell.
Mark Stahl's first shift without playing a game this season.
Driven back up by Mazaros. You can only imagine the excitement as well as issues he might have with conditioning, but he's been skating for a couple of weeks and had contact for 10 days as a shot into the catching glove of the netminder Lundqvist. The The logos dictate that this would be the reaction to the first save by the Rangers. Pierre Maguire is inside the glass.
Well, there are two issues right now. One is this cascading noise from this massive crowd and almost 50,000 people. The other thing is a win. Right now it seems to be favoring the Philadelphia Flyers, but it's ever shifting, so that's one of the problems. But you see the flags. You see the American flag that's bundled up right there. This is a shifting wind right now, and it's causing some problems. But wide open hockey, and Eddie and Doc, I can't believe the precision. With this large crowd and the nerves, these guys are really on it early on here.
So your sense is they've gotten past the crowd pretty quickly.
The coaches really have to be loud on the bench, because this is the loudest I've ever heard it down here.
And not only the verbal, but also the physical, making sure that you're going in behind and tapping players on the back of the shoulders to let them know that they are up.
Wheeling shot is deflected wide. Harry Zollner checked with that. The two coaches, John Tortorella of the Rangers, Peter Laviolette of the Flyers, are the winningest American-born NHL coaches. This one is pushed around behind by Henrik Lundqvist, battled for there by Delzato. Continues to work Michael Delzato, and it's taken on, can be worked back up by Ruslan Fedotenko. Big Mike Rupp out of Cleveland, Ohio, 71 in the white jersey, went after that one, but it can be controlled and settled down a little bit now by the Flyers and Andreas Lilja, Andre Mazaros, and then on through. Jaromir Jagr brings it on, crosses and fed one. It is played by Claude Giroux, set up for Jagr, quickly spiked away by Rupp. Kicked on back to Ruslan Fedotenko.
I'm sure Jagr is trying to get that puck to Lilja or Giroux, both of them jumping into the play. Good idea. Get your defenseman involved. We saw the Rangers with a good chance from Delzato jumping into play and airmailing one over the crossbar of Sergei Bobrovsky.
Jordan Tortorella is furious because they think there shouldn't be an icing, but there is. Now their fourth line is stuck on the ice, the Rangers' fourth line, against the Stars of the Philadelphia Flyers. Peter Laviolette changed quickly. See Tortorella, he's not happy. He said they waved off the icing. They didn't. Fresh legs coming on the ice for Philadelphia, tired legs, and the fourth line legs of the Rangers.
Yeah, you got the Shen, Voracek, Talbot line out there with the Giroux line coming off after a long shift.
Bordone tried to play it further and must play back at center.
Good play there by Mike Ruff.
Offside is called. Expand your hockey experience with the Verizon StarCam on NBCSports.com and NHL.com. Today we'll focus on Claude Giroux and the Flyers in the first and third periods, Ryan Callahan and the Rangers in the second. Verizon StarCam is available now at NBCSports.com and NHL.com. A recent rule change in the NHL pointed up just what Pierre and you were saying, that the offending team on an icing can no longer make a player change. That's the penalty for doing it. Earlier, you could do that just to take the heat off your goaltender, and you could also make player changes. Darren Pang.
Well, I'm right behind Sergei Bobrovsky, fellas, and Pierre was talking about the wind. Obviously, inside the rink, I talked to the goaltenders about it. They are protected a little bit, but because it's swirling, there are some inconsistencies. So far, Brizgalov having no problems whatsoever.
Darren, pretend you're a goaltender right behind there. If a puck is dumped in high, would you lose it in the crowd?
No question about it. Because the fans are so far away, the perception, everything is different. And that's the one thing that Henrik Lundqvist told me yesterday after his practice. So you're right. And both goalies did tell me that you, if puck around the glass, stay in the net, because it takes some funny bounces, as we well know.
Matt Reed could not help there. Brought on by the Rangers, and Brad Richards with a shot that steered wide. Ryan McDonough dropped it along, taken on and thrown out by Giroux. Escaping is Scott Hartnell, trying to work his way through it. Got it on to Giroux, who's moving right in. Pulled it. Couldn't get the shot away. A wonderful play made at the front of the net by Lundqvist. Another shot, and Lundqvist fought that one off. The battle at the half boards is thrown in front again and must be chased down by Jaromir Jagr. Onto the back now, Carl, a shot, and that one kicked loose. Giroux again, led on by Ryan Callahan of the Rangers. The puck lifted back out by Brad Richards. And then spun back in for a shift change by Giroux. The hit is on Dan Girardi, one of the better hitters in the NHL. Anisimov falls down, skids, but still able to play it on the wing. Gabrick is shot! And that one is blocked away. Oh, my.
Well, what an effort by Artem Anisimov. as he goes to the ice, but he still has presence of mind to get two hands on a stick, get this puck to Marian Gaborik, and tries to elevate it over the shoulder. Good stop there by Bobrovsky.
How about Hartnell in this situation? A Claude Giroux coming in all alone on Lundqvist, and Lundqvist is there with the right pad. Skillful play by Hartnell and Giroux, but even better goaltending with the stick by Lundqvist.
Yeah, the knob of the stick denied the opportunity for Claude Giroux. And Henrik Lundqvist pretty aggressive on that. He's more one to kind of stay deep in his net, but I think the element of surprise with Lundqvist coming out on top of the crease and taking away the time and space for Claude Giroux, the second leading point man in the entire National Hockey League.
When Giroux came off the ice, he was mad at himself. He was saying, bear down, he was yelling at himself.
Delzato rubbed down across the way by Braden Chen. Another chance in front, and that one is jabbed away.
Yeah, that was Jake Voracek. What a pass, what a play by Max Talbot along those boards to be able to stop the puck and make the pass all the way over. I believe the puck, Pierre, you got the best seat in the house for that play. It looked like to me from our vantage point that the puck was on edge. That's why Voracek wasn't able to get good wood on it.
You're absolutely right, Eddie. It was on edge, and that's why he couldn't get good wood on it. This is the best pace we've seen for one of these games, I think, man. This has been unbelievable early on.
Kind of like an indoor pace, isn't it? Here's Carl with a shot, and that one deflected and out of play.
And so far, the ice has held up really well. I know we're only about 6 minutes into this, but the ice seems fine.
I think that's where the National Hockey League has really done a better job of going to school over the course of the last four Winter Classics, allowing people to skate on it, allowing the teams to get on it a couple days before, let the ice tie in, bond a little bit, and it's come a long way since Buffalo between the Penguins and the Sabres.
One more try, deflected wide. Dan Craig is the ice guru, former facilities manager in Edmonton, Alberta, when the Oilers were very strong there. And even when they weren't, it wasn't because of the ice. They had some of the best. Led back on now to Wayne Simmons, and Simmons is able to march back in with it. Tries to shake through the defense. The puck went through. He did not. Chipped along and held neatly by Matt Reed, and then forced back in deep for Danny Briere. Briere banked one around behind, ricocheted off of Simmons in front, and can be handed back out and controlled by the Rangers.
Good job there by Mark Stahl on Briere.
Brian Boyle put it into the catching glove of Bobrovsky. Early stages, no score. The NHL Foundation and Honda have partnered to benefit the Ronald McDonald House Charities. To aid in transporting families to and from the hospital, Honda will donate a redesigned 8-passenger 2012 Honda Pilot to the Ronald McDonald House in the city of the winning team today. For every shot on goal during today's game, the NHL will contribute $200 towards programs that improve the health and well-being of children. For the NHL Foundation and Honda, the biggest assist happens off the ice, and already $1,400 are racked up because the shots are 4-3 in favor of the Rangers.
Never a bad play, especially especially at this time, Doc.
Yes.
Doc and Eddie, I just talked to Matt Reed during the last TV timeout. He said actually the quality of the ice is as good as it is across the street over at the Spectrum, or the old Spectrum, the new building.
Wells Fargo Center.
Yes.
On the grounds of the old JFK Stadium where so many Army-Navy games were tested. Here's Gaborik trying to shake by and can't. Terrific defensive play by Matt Carl there. And so Carl will just wait behind. 6¾ minutes have been played here in a scoreless first period. Both goaltenders have had to be good so far on the rare chances that have come to them. The quality has been high. Rolled along by James Van Riemsdyk. Bourbon drops back defensively as it's thrown by Harry Zolnarczyk out of Brown University, but can be played right back ahead. Stepan working on the wing, and Gaborik is pressed to the half boards right at the Geico side. Bourdon tried to work further. Second effort pushed it ahead. Van Riemsdyk, a one-time New York Rangers fan growing up, who was glad his parents didn't bring his old jersey because he's playing for Philadelphia. This is Stepan with it. Stepan leads. Anisimov, a shot. It's deflected up high. Ripped along by Bourdon, and it is chased down all the way back by Anton Strahlman. He and Michael Delzato, the defense, as the Rangers change it up once again.
Good job there by Strahlman. His teammates, his forwards, were in the middle of a change. Instead of trying to pass it up to nobody, he just went in behind the net, allowed the players to get on the ice and make a change.
So the change complete. Now they can start it up. This one pinballed to center. Braden Coburn chopped it further. Ricocheted off of Carl Hagelin. And this one is loose, but an offside call. Weather always of interest, and so we call on Jim Cantore.
Hey, Doc, yeah, just getting a quick check on the radar, and off to our west, just like we see in the summertime, you can get these little pop-up showers. This time, they're in the winter mode, so we're talking about a chance of a flurry or maybe even a little period of light snow, but as you know, guys, it's just going to add to the wonderful atmosphere that exists here in Philadelphia today.
All over it is Jim Cantore. There was a large mass northwest of Buffalo at about this time, and it did arrive. But we'll just see. And then, of course, part of the joy of watching this is to see how everybody reacts to what happens when the conditions change.
It's about the elements.
It's not a loud crowd. It's a watchful crowd right now as both teams continue to probe. Mazzaro spins back, lays it back on for the carry further. Matt Reed was plowed into there by Strawman. It is Simmons dumping it around behind. Danny Briere tried to center. Good defense played on him. Reaching in yet again, Ruslan Fedotenko. Pivoting now is Delzato. Pretty good forecheck put on by the Flyers here. Something to try and tie up the opposition in their own end of the ice. Not only get them tired, but get them to cough it up so you get a good chance. Here's Lundqvist pushing one along. That is caught by Brandon Prust and put quickly right back into play. Though it is shaken back on by Carl and in stride now up with it as Hartnell picks up Giroux, lays it on the board for it. Giroux matched by Ryan McDonough as it came across the net mouth wide. Pretty good hitting by Brian Boyle. Big 6'7", native of Massachusetts. So long to get it is Carl. Pursued by Mitchell. John Mitchell couldn't reach him before he passed it ahead. Pushed away just from the reach of Jágr and lobbed back in. So they're pretty well able to roll lines here.
Yeah, there's a lot of matchup going on. You got Girardi and McDonough out there against the Giroux line every time that they're on the ice.
No penalties yet. Drive by Coburn. Oh, and that one blocked off of Lundqvist.
Yeah, he fought that one off.
Think it knuckled on him?
Might have just at the last second, but it seemed like it got on him a little quicker than he was expecting.
Fed across by Jágr. Set up for Coburn, and that one waffle-boarded away by Lundqvist. Again, the Flyers on the attack around behind. It's Jágr trying to shake one in front. That one defended away. Good job done by Dan Girardi. And more up the boards, and Mitchell is able to twist one on the backhand out. Shift change time for the Rangers.
I think maybe that speaks to the point that Darren Payne was talking about a little bit earlier, of playing the goaltending position and seeing where pucks and trying to find them, not only in the crowd, but also you got scoreboards on either in behind either goaltender with a black support in behind, and that gets lost with the black puck.
This is the Bridgestone NHL Scoreless Winter Classic. Time now for Edward Jones FaceTime. Pierre is with coach Peter Laviolette of the Flyers.
Because we're outside, you guys have to brave the elements. You have to change your game planning?
I don't think so. It looked like we had a little trouble getting our legs under us early on there. But I think, you know, these big events for me, after the planes go by and the first shift gets in there, it gets down to hockey. It's the one-on-one battles. It's all the things, same things that apply in a regular hockey game.
You know this team so well. It looks like you're trying to come out of your own zone through the middle of the ice. Is that because they're taking away the boards?
Well, they come so hard with two guys on the forecheck. So if we can get our heads up and hit the middle of the ice, we might be able to get some speed, kick it out wide, and generate some shots. I think shots are the best opportunity. Take them, put as many as we can at the net today.
You want a Stanley Cup? What's this like?
Well, this is awesome. Anytime I can see you in a hat, Pierre, that's good stuff.
Thanks, Peter.
Both of these coaches have won Stanley Cups. Laviolette with Carolina in 06. And John Tortorella with the Tampa Bay Lightning in 04. And both of them are bareheaded on a cold day in Philadelphia.
Due to the fact they're not follically impaired.
We won't go there. Meanwhile, it is picked up and rolled to the front and punched away on the try that was coming from Braden Schenn. Unable to escape for a breakaway that time because he did not have the puck. Gabrick tripped up Max Talbot, who moves ahead, and Lundqvist had to answer that one.
That was a good play by Andreas Lilja. As you mentioned, Doc, Gabrick looked like he was shot out of a cannon through the middle of the ice and was going to be in all alone. And a good play coming back on the back check.
Jaromir Jagr went circle to circle. Bourdon returned it. Set up for Claude Giroux. Ripped back in deep. There'll be no icing here. Ryan McDonough reversed it along and then was given a heavy thump by Scott Hartnell. Centering pass in front. Jabbed at there. And it is held outside and a big crowd gathers.
McDonough's got a pretty good headlock there on Scotty Hartnell with a little extra jab at Lundqvist.
Well, the good forecheck by the Flyers create this chance, and it was Scotty Hartnell comes in. There's Ryan McDonough in behind it. There's a good finish check. And the takeaway by Claude Giroux. And when you have pressure, and we heard Peter talking, Peter Laviolette, the head coach of Flyers, talking to Pierre about the Rangers forecheck, is that the middle of the ice is open. No different. Rangers on the breakout trying to go up the board. Giroux takes it away and is able to get the puck to the front of the net.
As advertised, man, there's not a lot of love between these two teams.
Yeah, I noticed that Hartnell was saying something to the Rangers about the weather conditions as he came by. Peter Laviolette's upset that an extra change to the Rangers has been allowed.
And I think also, too, Doc, that this faceoff comes outside the zone. And the only reason that that would happen is that the defenseman for the Flyers came in below the top of the circle. And that's why the faceoff comes outside. So good opportunity and a missed opportunity for the defenseman creeping in.
McDonough and that into the catching glove of Bobrovsky. Check out Winter Classic Extra on NBCSports.com and NHL.com for 4 online-only bonus cameras, in-game highlights, and more. Go to NBCSports.com or NHL.com to learn more. Scott Hartnell, 19 in orange, is a chatter. Number 19 proudly worn by one of the cleverest forwards in Flyers history, Rick McLeish, who turned 61 tomorrow. A lot of great 60-year-old players were here for the alumni game 2 days ago. Delzato with a shot that's turned aside by Bobrovsky.
Some not 60 retired felt like 60 during the alumni game.
The breaks put on by Ryan Callahan. Rochester native tried to work it on through, still out of the jam up of two players aside. It came along for Brad Richards. Slung one in front that rattled on around and must come back out to center. Chased down though by Hartnell. Good close off on Callahan. Hartnell fed one. Giroux got it. Wanted to work the wing for Jagr. Followed up by Hartnell. Set back for Tiemannen. And a glove grab made by Lundqvist. Oh my.
How about this puck movement, Edzo? This is unbelievable talent by the Philadelphia Flyers.
And it all started because of the play by Scotty Hartnell. Hartnell to Giroux and then Kimmo Tiemannen jumping into the play. Actually thought that Giroux had a chance to shoot the puck right away, but understanding that Kimmo Tiemannen was going to jump into a soft little spot and a good save. Outstanding save by Henrik Lundqvist.
And give Tiemannen some credit because he was vocalizing to Claude Giroux, I'm there, and Giroux heard him.
Shots on goal that would have been goals otherwise are 8-6 in favor of the Flyers. Offside is called. Darren Pang is near Henrik Lundqvist.
I am right behind Henrik Lundqvist. I just had a chance to go over to the New York Rangers bench where Marty Biron's the backup goalie. I said, did he change anything with his gear, anything underneath? He said, nothing whatsoever. That glove save there is typical of Lundqvist, and that's what surprised Giroux early on. Lundqvist stays deep in his net, very deep, and for him to come out on Giroux, that must have shocked the heck out of Giroux because that is untypical of the way Lundqvist plays.
Yeah, surprised me, Panger, for the aggressiveness of Henrik Lundqvist. Again, you got to be able to get that head up right away to understand, to see the positioning of the goaltender. Very deep in his net, you're probably better off to shoot the puck when he plays it across the goal line. If he's out on top of the crease, you look to make a move and try to deke him and try to get a better position to shoot the puck or deep.
Lazaro's fed it ahead. Wayne Simmonds could not work further. Mitchell led it back, and Brian Boyle out of Boston College couldn't generate a play. Away from Brandon Dubinsky. This is held now by Matt Carl. And all the way back down. 4 players for the Rangers, 4 players for the Flyers are college trained.
Hey, Pierre, we're really close to it, more so than we are during a regular season game. It looks like shadows. Now, we haven't talked a lot about that, but it seems like there are more shadows now on the ice than there were a little bit earlier. But can you lose the puck in a shadow out there?
I think you can, but right now I don't think it's an issue. But I agree with you. The shadows are definitely starting to creep up.
cold and overcast is the best. And there is a huge cloud where the sun normally is at this time of day. And that has helped a lot. The sun by this time has dipped down below the top of the stands level. Bobrovsky able to flip it along. Oh, Matt Carl caught one of the Rangers up high, Anisimov. And the play continues. Jake Voracek tried to throw it to the front, no luck there. Kept along though and worked back across to Carl for the one-time shot, blocked down in front. Good job done there by Stu Bickel. Roll back along for Bordeaux to play further for the Flyers. But banked around behind and Bickel has it. They wanted to lead Brandon Trust. They might get there. They've got a two-on-one. Stepan played it across, but it's blocked away to the corner. Everything looked pretty good for the Rangers there as Stepan and Trust hit the line. Forced back along to Mike Ruff. His towering centerman threw that one behind. Trust is jousted off of it. These are two of the top three penalty-getting teams in the NHL. No penalties have been called so far. Chopped on across, Van Riemsdyk with it. All of this on a delayed offside that's wiped and then lifted back in. Boy, it's quick play, isn't it?
It is. It is really quick. And the beauty of being in our location, just saying we're only about 25 feet in behind Pierre, probably up about 8 or 10 feet. There's a really loose sight of how great and how quick this game is when you're not down there at ice level four, an actual National Hockey League game. It is really quick, and the ice looks outstanding from the position we are.
It's what's changed the most since they took the red line out after the lockout in 2005. The game's just so much quicker, and every year it gets quicker and quicker.
Zolnarchuk took the hit. Left behind by Van Riemsdyk.
Good hit from McDonough in behind.
Lundqvist with yet another save. Lob back out to center. Will it be a breakaway for Callahan? Oh, spiked away from behind by Mazaros. Strong defensive play there, but it's Callahan with a shot. It went wide. Now Jágr away from Hagelin. Then Van Riemsdyk. Then near center. Shaken back in by Girardi. And set up by Bobrovsky. Nearing the 16-minute mark in elapsed time in this first 20-minute period. Giroux sets it up for Jaromir Jágr. Jágr trying to break on through and does a backhander. Oh, and it wouldn't go! A big goal went up from the crowd there as Jágr, with all the skill and the credentials of being one of the league's best scorers in history, could not score on that one. Anisimov dumped it back along. It's swatted back out again by Coburn and carried up the wing by Hartnell. Here's Hartnell firing, and it's shrugged away by Lundqvist. Rolled back in by Stepan, and that one to the corner, and Stepan goes to get it. Jabbed around behind, and it's Gavrik. Oh, was he ever worked over there by Giroux. Two-a-side battle. Gavrik centered one. Oh, and Anisimov with a shot that wouldn't go. Bobrovsky got in the way of that one. Wonderful action here in the last 3 1/4 of the first period. Wayne Simmonds works up the boards. Got it on back to Carl, who's played a lot already in this game. That one careened back out to center again, but can be played by Stepan and then Simmonds, and then some extra after the whistle and the first penalty call of the day. 3:02 to go. First period. Action aplenty, but no score.
Orange and red sometimes clash. Not in this case. It's comfortable. A look at the lucky fans enjoying the game from the Xfinity couch, the best seat in the house. When it comes to the NHL, Xfinity gives you a front row seat all season long. Xfinity, your home for the most live sports.
Well, what a great chance for Jaromir Jágr. He leaves, heads into the dugout after a great chance. Here's Jaromir Jágr, but this is a set play. He's going to end up circling in like this, but watch where this puck comes from. Claude Giroux with the great one touch. There's Jágr, right part of your screen, little one touch, and then here comes Jágr right through the defense. Girardi and McDonough takes the shot. What a stop by Henrik Lundqvist, but a set play off a set breakout by the Philadelphia Flyers.
Matt Carl with the slash. Power play Ranger, sponsored by Verizon 4G. And that one snapped up from the stick of Brad Richards by Bobrovsky. Rangers power play has been a sore spot lately. In the last 6 games, they've only connected on 1 of 17, as you see from way up high. The action in the near left corner. Delzato holds. 2:45 to go, first period. Weaving his way along, Delzato dropped it off. Brad Richards brings it on. Off of Callahan, but he recovers. Hunted down by Coburn. Tripping call is coming up. It'll be against the Rangers. Delayed call is on. Until the Rangers touch, there'll be no whistle. Coburn with this. Let it back out for the feet across with speed. It's Tiemannin. Tiemannin walks ahead trying to shake by. Cannot, but plays in the corner. And Callahan will touch.
Eddie, how about the hockey sense for Claude Giroux? This penalty is all because of hockey sense from 28 in orange.
The anticipation. Stick on the ice. He takes away an opportunity, and there you see Richards getting in the way of Claude Giroux. It's just understanding what teams are going to do, Pierre, on their power play and know what the options are of the puck carrier. Yes, the guy with the puck is the most important player on the ice to a certain extent because he dictates what happens, but the guys on the ice around really are able to read and see options and take them away, and that's what Giroux did.
Pitch to the back. Cordon threw it back in deep. Danny Briere with it there. Tried to hurry it in front. It's cut off and steered right back out again. Very authoritatively by Mark Stahl. Got it onto Dubinsky. Led across to Gavrik off his skate. And it came to the front of the net before it was punted aside. Braden Shen able to step back out with it. Led it back up the wing. Bordeaux wants to shake by. Wedged off. Good defensive play made there so that Dubinsky can curl. As Strahlman was the one who did that. Mark Stahl takes over there. You may hear the wind whistling through the windscreens of our microphones here. It has been a very strong wind all afternoon. We're down to the last 90 seconds.
Yeah, it's just a little bit of a strong gust there in the last 10 or 12 seconds.
Coburn dropped it back along. Nearly halfway through, one penalty to the Rangers. 13 from now, the Flyers will get a man advantage. The trigger pull failed from Coburn. Carried back on by McDonough, and his shot had to be steered away by Bobrovsky. Oh, was he ever worked over high and hard by Braden Coburn? It is a collision sport. It is Hartnell trying to stick handle through the traffic. Very persistently, it is Ryan Boyle able to nudge this one ahead. Brought back on by Anisimov, and a shot fluttered wide. Right back out in front again. A shot by Stepan is blocked down.
Boy, that hit Kimmo Tiemannin right in the open hand, the left hand. The shot block on Derek Stepan.
Here's Mazzaros, a shot, and that had to be speared away by Lundqvist.
Tiemannin's coming off looking at his left hand right now.
What a hit on Girardi by Hartnell. Puck led to the back. Drive by Carl, and that had to be turned aside.
There's Ryan McDonough with the shot block, moving right to left.
Voracek dropping back. A couple of swats his way from Brian Boyle. No shots on the power play, abbreviated as it was, for the Flyers. To the last 10 of the period. Icing is called. So some concern about Jágr, who departed.
It looked like he was moving fine, Doc, and looked like he was laboring at all as he was heading to the dugout.
Jim McCross, and the fine physical trainer for the Philadelphia Flyers, is still on the Flyer bench, so I don't know if it was a physical thing or a skate thing for Jágr.
Well, this is the first 20 minutes. One last try, skittered wide off a Flyer defender.
A little push in there with Michael Delzato and Scotty Hartnell.
Some of your best verbiage is as you peel away, right, when the linesmen are in. Coming up during the first intermission, a tribute to the infamous Broad Street Bullies. Fun to play against, weren't they, Eddie? Plus Bob Costas and Mike Milbury will examine how this New York-Philly rivalry progressed in the first period. That's ahead in the first intermission report. Pierre McGuire and Wayne Simmonds.
Thanks a lot, Doc. You've never played in one of these before. What's the biggest difference?
You can feel the wind, you know, the back checking is kind of coming uphill from then that we were coming, but no, it's been awesome so far. There's 45,000 people here, you know, and they're all cheering for the Flyers, so it's great.
People think it's just a one-time spectacle and you're done, but there's a lot of bad blood between these two teams, and I saw you involved with some of it. What's the carryover?
Yeah, you know, it's I think ever since the first exhibition game we played this year, you know, we've had battles every single game, and you know, I think it's just obviously it's a rivalry between the two teams. I don't see that stopping anytime soon.
Quickly, what's the key to beating Henrik Lundqvist?
I think we got to get traffic, get bodies in front.
Thanks, Wayne.
No problem. Thank you.
Doc?
Stay tuned as Bob Costas and Mike Milbury are standing by to bring you the first intermission report right after these messages. A minor apiece in that first period. Flyers with 12 shots on goal. The Rangers with 9. Bobrovsky and Lundqvist outstanding. Welcome back to the Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic. 14 weeks from today. That'll be a busy place. Home opener for the Phillies against the Florida Marlins. They will have come home from a 3-game opening series in Pittsburgh against the Pirates. Pierre, we were concerned about Jaromir Jagr. What do you think?
Had a chance to talk to Jimmy McCross and the trainer of the Philadelphia Flyers, and he said Jaromir Jagr should be good to go, nothing serious.
No carryover penalties nor power plays into the second period. As it gets darker here in South Philadelphia, the shadows get a little bit long.
There seems to be a big sunspot right in front of Sergei Bobrovsky with that sun setting in behind down the third base line. There's something to keep an eye on. A big shine in the high slide area in the defensive zone for the Flyers.
Poked along now for Bordeaux. Lobbed on to Carl, outletted to Wayne Simmons. Simmons skids on further, and the puck goes on its own around behind where Lundqvist had to play. Kick loose from Simmons, played by Matt Reed, and the bouncer was blocked aside and then worked for behind by Simmons again. Here's Wayne Simmons, led it onto the back. Shot by Bordeaux, kicked off of Mitchell, and Bordeaux being pursued there and whacked at a couple of times by Mitchell, and then run in too hard.
Brian Boyle with the big hit.
One of the things speculated about outdoor hockey was there wouldn't be much hitting. Well, in the first one, Paul Gostad of Buffalo was recorded with 10 hits. And that one deflected out of play and within an arm's length of Eddie Olchek.
I'll be right back.
Yeah, there it is. That's an authentic game used puck there.
Yeah, that's a good finish check on there. Brian Boyle doing a good job there on Bordeaux.
Boyle, a former star at Boston College, first round pick at the LA Kings.
It was good to see some of the old Flyers and some of the old Rangers before the game started, but particularly in that intermission. Warren Hart, the wonderful vocalist with God Bless America, all a part of championship runs here. Eddie Olchek, part of a championship run 1994 with the New York Rangers, as Lundqvist had to make another stop. Here's Gabrick able to step by and move on in. Gabrick with a shot that steered wide. Another try is blocked off. Jammed to the back. McDonough shot. Oh, and that one was a fooler for Bobrovsky, but tipped by one of his defensemen.
That was a high stick by Gabrick. That's why the faceoff's coming outside. The linesman caught that. Jean Morin. Right in the slot, Gabrick tried to chip that McDonough shot, and his stick was up high.
So we got that one wrong, and Pierre, on the front row of the Indianapolis 500 down there, was able to catch it.
I agree with what you and Eddie were talking about with the shadows. It's definitely a different perspective and something that the players aren't used to seeing in NHL rinks.
Well, it's sort of surreal to look across the way and to see the sun peeking through the first deck and the second. Meanwhile, this is jabbed toward the front. No luck there. Mark Stahl, who's been very effective in this first game of the season, played it out. Teaming in across, led back up the wing, but off the stick of Jake Voracek. Brad Richards brings it on. Former Dallas Star jabbed at one, trying to work it further, blocked off by the Flyer defense.
Nice play there by Carl Hagelin. Wasn't able to make a direct pass with his stick, so he decided to use his skate and got that puck to Richards coming through the middle of the ice.
Four-year performer at the University of Michigan, Hagelin.
And not only having to fighting the elements of the opposition, but also the wind, and you talk about those shadows. So a lot of things going on that you got to deal with.
Zolnarchek with one that was blocked down. Another try, shinnied up the outside of the cage and drew a big awe from the crowd. Well, it's fun to hear them react to anything, isn't it? Because it's 45,000 or so strong. Played on now by Strawman, and that one jabbed away by Bobrovsky. Zellner checked with that. Wheeling drive, ricocheted wide, jabbed around behind by Carl, backhanded up the board, Van Riemsdyk, and poked back out to center. A lot of these players have stories about playing outdoors in their youth. Van Riemsdyk is somewhat short. He said, we didn't get a lot of really great ice in central New Jersey, but when we did, it was fun. It's just it wasn't predictable. Swatted on now by Mike Rupp, led back out, and as far as Bordone, to hand across to Mazaros. Flyers just blasted back in from that center red line, and around the roulette wheel it goes. Mike Rupp able to drop it back in. St. Stephen's High School, Cleveland, Ohio for Mike Rupp. Right back along to Danny Briere and sent up for Simmons. Simmons charging ahead. Able to step by, and a shot went wide.
He walked around Mark Stahl again, playing in his first game this season. Not because of a concussion. Nice little stutter step there by Wayne Simmons to fake to the inside, get to the outside.
And a save made by Bobrovsky.
Eddie, wouldn't this be the most difficult thing for a defenseman, a transition chance like this?
Yeah, speed, understanding where the player is on the ice. But there you just kind of see him leaning over. He just kind of lost his balance enough to allow Wayne Simmons to take that shot. And again, another stop by Henrik Lundqvist with the part of his stick above his paddle. But that, the speed, you can practice all you want. Doc, you made mention about the practicing aspect of it. But to Pierre's question, I mean, it is the understanding and judging of the speed of the player. And he got so close to him where he kind of got into the front and the toes of his skates, lost his balance, and Simmons just avoided that and went down those right wing boards.
In 2 days, Newman and Penn State. On Friday, it will be Hershey and the Adirondack Phantoms in an American Hockey League game. There'll be an Olchek playing for Penn State.
Looking forward to that. I talked to Peter Lukow, the president of the Philadelphia Flyers, and just the importance of this game and what it means for the city and for the Flyers. They've done a wonderful job. Their organization should be very proud with everything that they've done for this Winter Classic.
Bordone with it on the pass from Max Talbot. That one could not be stopped by Voracek. Good pinch along by Carl. Good follow-up to keep play alive for Voracek behind. Voracek defended by Bickel and Stahl. Bickel able to play further, and it is Gabry.
Not a lot of sustained offense in this game. It's been a lot of one and done. Not a lot of play down low below the goal lines that we might see in a normal type of situation for both these teams inside.
Jágr led it across. Giroux fed off Jágr's stick into the corner. Played along by Talbot. Giroux feeds one, and that one chipped off a Ranger stick and back to center, retreating to play is Kimmo Tiemann. Brought on by Giroux and punched across by Hartnell. The attack continues. Not a lot of it very severe. Some of the better chances were earlier in the game. Let's take a look at the Coors Light cold hard facts. Included in the list, gallons and ballparks in Chicago and Boston as well as here. 70 broadcast cameras for all networks. 20,000 gallons of water needed for the rink here. And 47,000 plus attending today's game. 4,500 soft pretzels, 9,000 cheesesteaks, 10,000 hot dogs, 12,000 cups of hot coffee and chocolate. I would say probably by the end more than 12,000 of those. And none for Pierre. And I noticed that the young man who was filling the water bottles for the Flyers had eye black on. So it's pretty important for everybody to have it. Here's Boyle sending it back. Strawman, a shot! It's blocked up to the glass.
Beautiful pass there on the backhand by big Brian Boyle.
Simmons pulls that. Twisted back out. Might be an odd man rush for the Flyers, but it slows things at center. Purring his way back in as Matt Reed wanted to play behind, but could not. Mitchell played it along to Boyle. Back up the board for Davinsky, but nicely knocked away from him and played back in deeper. Danny Briere with it there. Taken right away and floated back off. What a one-on-one play has been very heavily contested, and you don't keep the puck very long.
Yeah, not a lot of room.
Off of Simmons, it comes out to center.
Isn't that kind of play a byproduct of rivalry-type situations? Both these teams know how important these points are in the standings.
Play stopped. Middle stages, second period. Just a discussion, no score. Time now for Honda's Name That Squirt. A flyer named Eric Desjardins is the adult in these two pictures. But who is the child?
Van Riemsdyk? Just guessing.
Your guesses are always really good. I think you went to the truck first. Do we have the answer? You are right, sir. Claude Giroux from Hearst, Ontario. Population 6,000, way up north. They've had snow for quite a while there on the ground. Brian Boyle in on this draw. Opposite Braden Shen, controlled by the Rangers. Boyle worked in deep. Just body work there. Led along now for the twisting play of Voracek. Nicely sent ahead. Shen there with Max Talbot. Shrugged down and Talbot able to poke it back deeper. One of the Penguin heroes of their 09 championship in seven games against Detroit, Max Talbot. Scored both goals. Lobbed on out, and this can be played further by the defense of Andreas Lilja. Lilja forces it along further. Lilja Swedish. Henrik Lundqvist as well, as this is moved right back into Shen. Jammed one across, and it careened back. Lilja up with it there, dumped it around behind. Gotten by Shen, but he's closed off effectively there by Mitchell. Back up it comes for Lilja. Has trouble with the checking of Boyle, and a shot was deflected wide.
Oh, beautiful play there by Jake Voracek to get the puck to Braden Shen to create that two-on-one.
Nudged along, but too far for the reach of Boyle. Played along by Shen again. Trying to get away from Mark Stahl. Shen yet again. Got it behind. Voracek with it. Protects and gets a little room. Nudged onto the back. Teaming in across. Held there for a drive by Coburn. Fought off and then covered by Lundqvist. Inside the glass with Pierre.
Well, one of the real stories in this game so far outside of the crowd and the ice has been Henrik Lundqvist of the New York Rangers. He's been absolutely stellar all night long. And you watch Henrik Lundqvist, it's the athleticism, it's the quickness, it's being square, having the flair for the dramatic as he did right there against Claude Giroux. And then this against Jaromir Jagr, keeping his team in the game. The art of being a quality goaltender, timely saves. Lundqvist gets that.
Here comes Gavrik, met by Timonen, and the shot is held by Bobrovsky.
Right off the set faceoff, Rangers win the draw. They just fired up the boards. Gavrik flying the zone. But Bobrovsky out, down, easy to absorb, but a set play off the draw by the Rangers.
One tried there by the Flyers, and hoping to come up with it was Hartnell. Did not get it that time, but here's a chance. They've got Van Riemsdyk ahead, and the pass is away. And another shot by Hartnell is blocked down. Dan Girardi on him. Van Riemsdyk saw it skip behind. Comes back up with it again.
No Jagr on this line with Giroux and Hartnell.
Interesting.
He's looking at Laviolette, saying, when do I get to go out? He's looking right at Laviolette now.
Save made by Lundqvist. The answer might be now.
He's right on the bench, just in front of Peter Laviolette and right beside Danny Briere, who just went on the ice.
So he's bypassed for right now. Danny Briere, who grew up in Quebec, his father took the individual pieces of skids, construction skids, to make a rink outside. Lived on to the back, and this one can be spun across. So 4 inches tall is not very good for boards, but by the end of the winter, there were piles of snow behind, so you had the effect of walls all around. This is ragged further and just away from the reach of Briere, and then a little reach also freed the puck up for Anisimov. He duels all the way, but it has worked along now for the Flyers to recoil with Carl playing it into some traffic, and Bordeaux not able to handle too well. Ryan Callahan swaggers with that. Jostled a bit by Carl, led onto the back, and Strawman was unable to hold.
And Bordeaux had no idea where that puck was. He just understood that the Rangers were coming. Carl Hagelin with that great speed, putting him into a tough spot and not able to get a chance.
Over 9 minutes played here in the second period. Stick save made by Lundqvist on the shot that came from Briere. Jostling in now and trying to play it to the outside with Simmons, but now Briere holds. Hopes for Simmons, but instead it's Delzato. Quickly played again at center. By the standards of indoors or outdoors, this is a scrappy game. Not at all surprising, and it's been fast. We get an offside call.
Again, you just speak to the rivalry situation between the two teams. It's amazing. And a player like Brandon Press brings that intensity.
We talked about the lack of consistent offense from either team, and it just goes to the defensive posture and the structure that each one of these teams have, of just making sure that you're going to outnumber in your own zone. And it's been a lot of one and done. And I agree with Mike Milbury when he's talking to Bob Costas in the first intermission about the aspect of that first period. The majority of the play was for the Flyers, but we got the Rangers had some quality chances as well. But this period's pretty much even to this point with offensive opportunities.
The race is on again. Sean Couturier almost got it away from Anisimov. Quickly back up the boards, and it was away from Kiemannin. Boy, good stand-up checking by Braden Coburn yet again, the big Flyers defenseman. Volnarchuk rushes right back on, has Couturier with him, but that is forced back across, though it will be kept at center. And nice twist by Volnarchuk. Back over for Van Riemsdyk, and a glove grab is made by Henrik Lundqvist. You're watching the Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic. Time now for Edward Jones FaceTime. Pierre is with the Rangers coach John Tortorella.
First period looked like they were dominating. Now you're back in it. Did you make any adjustments?
No, I don't think either team has been dominating. It's a game where you got to chase pucks down because it's bouncing all over the place. We want to try to be more physical. We want to try to keep our game as simple as possible.
Because it's an outdoor game, John, do you have to go with a longer bench because of the wind, or you just roll because everything, the conditions are equal for both teams?
No, we go about our business the way we always do. We're looking for certain matchups and certain situations, and we're trying to coach this way we always do.
Thanks, John.
My pleasure.
Well, there's Jaromir Jagr, two shifts in the second period, over 10 minutes of ice time played so far between the Flyers and Rangers. Only a minute and 8 seconds in those two shifts for Jaromir Jagr.
A 3-on-2 developing for the Rangers as Dubinsky has Callahan up the wing. Laid it around the wall where it is Carl spinning, but knocked down by Boyle. Punched it back on, hoping for Callahan. No luck there. Dubinsky furls in. Oh, and he sent Bourdon down to the ice. By the Flyers defensively, it's Hartnell dropping it back. More battling at center.
Now Bourdon and Dubinsky battling in behind the play. Bourdon lost his glove. Now he lost his stick as Dubinsky knocked it out of his hand. Looks like Bourdon wanted to dance with Dubinsky.
There is another name for dancing, and it usually costs 5 minutes. Played along now by Hartnell and back in deep.
That's a long waltz.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Finesse move in front fails. Hartnell tries something else. It's onto the back, but it misfires for Mazaros and drops further. Pierre, are you noticing a lot of bouncing pucks there?
Right now I am.
Okay. Carried ahead by Danny Briere. Briere to the outside with it now. Backhands one that is deflected up high and out of play.
Nice play there by Michael Delzato. Talk about the big hit. Brandon Dubinsky, Marc-Andre Bourdon. Like it was just about to touch that puck. I've seen that, Pierre, called his interference sometimes. It's that timing play. You're anticipating that the guy's going to touch the puck. If he's in the vicinity or if he's around the puck, more times than not, the referees will let the guys play, and then in behind the play, here's what happened.
Right, it's a great non-call. That's what hockey's all about, fighting for your ice. Kudinsky's trying to establish physical territory and win a battle for the puck.
It is Wayne Simmonds, matched by Delzato. Help from Hagelin for the Rangers. Knife back, and right there for it is Simmonds again. Tries the other way for Danny Briere. Slowed it and played for Simmonds. Pinching along was Coburn. Got it back for the shot that is deflected wide. Pulling free was Briere, canceled right out effectively by Strollman. It is Briere again. Tried to work to the outside that time and get a pass away, could not. Drive by Coburn, and that one rattled wide.
It did not look like Henrik Lundqvist saw that puck at all.
Jammed off the short glass. Bouncer kept by Simmonds. Steps to the outside and slipped one that ricocheted across the net mouth wide. Taking it out is Simmonds again. Boy, he's been a powerhouse, hasn't he? Simmonds led it to the back. Here's Coburn faking now, trying to get away from the sliding Hagelin, and we get a stoppage of play.
The net might be off.
Eddie, is that the longest offensive sequence you've seen by any team?
Yeah, it is, Pierre, and I think it's due to the hustle there of Briere, Reed, Simmons doing an outstanding job down low. But that last shot from the back end from the Flyers, I do not think that Henrik Lundqvist saw that puck at all. And now with the lights looking like they're taking full effect, not going to be a bad play at all just to get the puck to the net from any part of the ice. They're just trying to fight it off. There's the hustle. Support down low. There's Wayne Simmons. Gets the puck back to Braden Coburn. A little bit of a screen in front of the net, and opportunity gone by the wayside for the Flyers.
Oh, there's one that's going to go. The rebound score! Braden Schenn! First NHL goal, and it's in the Winter Classic.
Matt Carr, what a smart play. Never a bad thing. Put the puck on goal. 25 in orange.
Well, Braden Schenn wins the faceoff. And good hustle there by Matt Carl. And a big rebound given up by Henrik Lundqvist. But Schenn was the guy that won the draw. The quick little play by Carl. Big rebound. 1-0 lead for the Flyers.
Eddie, as that puck's going to the net, it dipped and it bounced on Henrik Lundqvist. So while it was in the air, it bounced at the last second. That led to the juicy rebound. And Braden Schenn. There's a Philadelphia leap. Can you say that, Doc?
Yeah, I guess. You just did. Was Danny Savret, who scored against Boston. And that was his first. And this one is held to the back of the cage and play is stopped. What a thrilling thing this must be for someone who is only 20 from the western part of Canada, the city of Saskatoon.
Watch this puck come in and it dips right there. There's the bounce. That's what made it so tough for Lundqvist. It changed almost like a knuckleball at the last second.
Well, there's Braden Schenn. Talk about him winning a faceoff. Watch his route he takes. He wins the draw. He circles out, waiting to see what's going to happen, and the puck comes right to him. Great things happen when you go to the traffic areas. And to Pierre's point, very difficult for Henrik Lundqvist to be able to absorb that shot from Matt Carl.
This is one back to Carl and Bordona. Shot all fought off by Lundqvist. A jam play there, and Lundqvist able to seal it up as James Van Riemsdyk was trying to free it.
Win a faceoff, create a chance. Jean Couturier wins this draw. Matt Carl gets it over to Marc-Andre Bourdon, and then the redirect right in front for James Van Riemsdyk to the right of Henrik Lundqvist.
John Tortorella's not messing around. He's put Anisimov on to take this faceoff rather than Brian Boyle. And Anisimov goes for the scramble draw.
Bordona shot, and that one blocked down in front. May have gone off Zolnarczyk of the Flyers. Meanwhile, it's led ahead, and this one blocked off by Bordone. Tries to play back ahead, but it's cut and angled back where Matt Carl can lug it back with the toss back down. Couturier is run into by Dan Girardi. Van Riemsdyk trying to go further, cannot. Couturier back up the board. The rookie at 18 got it on to Van Riemsdyk. Anisimov was run into. Zolnarczyk with a hit on Anisimov.
How many guys go to Brown University, never get drafted and play in the National Hockey League? Eddie, didn't your brother go there?
He's just the general manager with the Edmonton Oilers, but big hit there by Big Harry.
Haglund fires it back in. Bobrovsky steered it ahead. Carried back on by Hartnell. Delzato contended with him. Spun on the play was Giroux. All of it legal. Jostled around to Giroux behind the net. Claude Giroux angled it back. Held there for a little flip that is gloved down and can be played back ahead and down by Ruslan Fedotenko.
Still no Jaromir Jagr.
Good point. So nothing serious. Strikes me as it might be just because it's gone on this long. Here's Talbot across. Score! Claude Giroux.
man rush because Michael Delzato gets caught up the ice.
A two-on-one, Maxime Talbot. Right part of your screen, Claude Giroux. What a pass by Talbot, forehand, backhand. Remember in the first period, the breakaway by Claude Giroux. Very similar situation. Goes to the same move, but makes it a little bit earlier and beats Henrik Lundqvist.
And he goes upstairs too, doesn't he, Eddie? Rather than go along the ice, get it up to the upper part of the net.
What a pass by Talbot.
Lundqvist forced that one around. I just wanted you to hear the crowd react to this. The ooh was not booing, it was the ooh for Giroux when his name was announced.
They were Giroux-ing.
That's right. Held to the outside and Rappaport, he scores! Mike Rapp with a Jager-like salute has cut the lead in half.
Huge goal for the Rangers. Well, there's Mike Rupp. He starts this play. And then Brandon Prust with a beautiful backhand pass. Skate to the left, shoot back to the right. And that's what we talked about, Sergei Bobrovsky. Down, he's going to take away the bottom part of the net. Skate left, shoot right. Rupp does it. 2-1 lead for the Flyers.
You like the fact Rupp doesn't stand still, though. He jumps into that dead spot in coverage, takes the pass from Prust, and snaps it home.
And also a screen there by Andre Mazaros. And there's the salute you made mention of, Doc.
We have a little ice issue that'll be attended to right now. Just to the left of Sergei Bobrovsky.
Three goals on the last four shots. Two goals in the last minute 55.
Well, there's Mike Rupp, the goal scorer. Watch him use the defender, Andre Mazaros, as a screen. Stop it right here. This is where Mazaros, and obviously he's shooting back through, and look at the goaltender, Sergei Bobrovsky, down looking. And what a perfect shot there by Big Mike Rupp. Darren Pang.
Edzo, I'm right behind Sergei Bobrovsky, and you are exactly right. It was a perfect screen. Mazaros couldn't get any piece of that right there. So the shot had some eyes there from Rupp. But the goaltender Bobrovsky, even though he's 6'1", he plays on a lower crouch. And in that first period, the Rangers, after the period, were really looking at their video, seeing how high they could go on him. Can they beat him over the shoulder? That one might have been intended there, but it was lower, handcuffed him, and he was completely screened.
It's almost in that situation. You like to see Andre Mazaros maybe come out a little bit. He was really deep, and I think he was probably there because the Flyers... There was kind of a little bit of a scrum right in front of the Ranger bench, and it was just a real quick play. But instead of fronting, coming up on Mike Rupp, and you have to understand who you're out there on the ice against. You have to understand the skill level of a particular player, and Mike Rupp is a grinding third or fourth line type of player. Is that if you're Mazaros, you could probably challenge him in that situation instead of staying back and creating the screen. But a perfectly placed shot by the big guy, Mike Rupp.
Little bit of snow starts to come down here in Philadelphia. Mike Rupp, a cup clinching goal for New Jersey in 03. His day at the Stanley Cup, he ate ice cream out of the big bowl. Somebody I know once had a horse eat grain out of the top of the Stanley Cup. That was Mr. Olczyk in 94 with the Rangers.
Go for Jim, Kentucky Derby winner. Only the best, Doc, only the best.
Little energy line right now for the Rangers. Boyle along with Callahan and Dubinsky trying to keep it going for the Rangers.
Dubinsky around behind. Puck lost. Voracek there. Oh, and he was hit by Dubinsky. Rolled off that and played it ahead. Voracek able to slip it back in. Was hit yet again, this time by Boyle. Charging ahead is Dubinsky to get this. Twisted one on Boyle while falling, sent it across the net mouth.
But isn't that Tortorella having a feel for the game right now? Just getting guys out. Now Callahan just went right after Bordeaux and flattened him.
Yeah, that's just really trying to change or continue the momentum he had after being down by two. No, only one.
Van Riemsdyk with a shot up high. Rebound! Oh, and getting that one as well was Lundqvist.
into a side battle. Couturier reaching in, pumped around behind the Van Riemsdyk. Pulled it to the back, got it there for Colburn. Across now for Tiemannin. Wristed one that went off of Gavrik and popped around behind. With the snow falling in Philadelphia, turnaround shot by Van Riemsdyk, ricocheted off of Lundqvist, and can be gathered in by Kimmo Tiemannin.
Well, that was a good idea there by Van Riemsdyk. Horrible angle, trying to catch the goaltender. Lundqvist, by surprise, just missed it a far side.
According to Jim Cantore's report, there were flurries nearby. They were in Mount Holly. Well, they're not only there now. Led back along by McDonough, trying to play it through as Boyle. Twisted around behind, and with it now is Hartman. Lobbed one on for Max Talbot, cross sticks with Ryan McDonough. McDonough for the Rangers, drops back further and plays it on to Dan Girardi.
Double shift for Boyle, Callahan, and Dubinsky right back over. So Tortorella sensing something right now with that threesome.
These are the promising young players of the present and future for the Rangers. It is McDonough shaking it back off. Off Dubinsky, wheeling it, it's Giroux, and that ricocheted wide off Talbot and cracked off the glass. Dubinsky there stepped in too well. Forced right back along by Giroux again. Taken by Carl. Ship change onto the Flyers. Drive by Mazaros, and unable to see that one was Lundqvist. It did not wind up behind it. Callahan cut off that try by Giroux. Callahan tried to nudge it back out, under 2.5 to go here in the second period. What a scene. What action. They are playing hard out here as this is brought back in by Giroux again. Along for Hartnell, but Girardi. Shoulder to shoulder, they go at it there. Two aside. Reaching in is Richards. Trying to slow down Simmons. He's able to rip it along, but it's just punted right back off a skate to Simmons. In a lot of traffic, Fedotenko is able to control this and slipped it out to center. Now brought back ahead by Richards. He's got a man up the wing. It's Haglund. Led it along. And it is now into the catching glove of the netminder, Bobrovsky. 1:49 to go. Second period, 2-1 Flyers.
Flyers, Rangers, inside, outside, doesn't matter. You're going to have physical hockey. Not a lot of room in that first period. As this game has gone on, the offense has picked up a little bit. The shadows coming into play. The light taking full effect here at Citizens Bank Ballpark. Scoring 3 goals here in the third period. Get pucks to the net. But you better have your head up and you better have your bucket on tight here tonight.
Voracek shoved it across. Poked right back along, and a chance around the front. Oh, and a passing combination from Stepan to Gavrik failed.
One too many passes.
It was Stepan's to Barry, right?
Sure was.
Talbot punched it ahead. That ricocheted back.
You want to get it to the leading goal scorer in the National Hockey League. I understand that. But in that situation, a giveaway by Voracek. Great play by Gavrik to allow that 2-on-0 to happen.
1:20 to go. Gavrik stepped into his man. Stepan played it along to him again. Gavrik worked over effectively there by Tiemannin, so it's Stepan again. Out of the University of Wisconsin, Stepan played it on now to the outside. It is Gavrik. Lifted one, and that one held by Bobrovsky.
Well, we heard John Tortorella, the head coach of the Rangers, talk to Pierre about bouncing pucks, and that puck started rolling on Voracek, but there's an opportunity where Derek Stepan was in probably within 5 feet of Sergei Bobrovsky and want to try a little bit give and go. Not a lot of room in that situation. Somehow you either got to get that puck from your backhand to your forehand, that means step on and get it to the net. Maybe there's a rebound there for Gabber going hard to the net.
Briere on the tie-up of the faceoff in the final minute of the second period. Already tried to work further, came back to him. Quick trigger pull was blocked off by Matt Reed. Brandon Dubinsky got it back. McDonough shot and that blocked. It is Simmons playing it ahead. Danny Briere moves back in. Briere shooting one, and it's blocked away by Lundqvist. Simmons working. Briere moves to the front, hoping for a pass. None comes. Matt Reed leans in. Came up with it, but only for a second because Brian Boyle was on him. Now it's Reed yet again. close-in battles here. Punched along for another play to be made by Wayne Simmons. He's got it on to Briere, and that one sent across the net mouth and blocked away with the goal stick. Reed with one. Ricochet poking at it is Briere. Still around behind, the battle continues. Briere led it back. Held by Mazzaros. Given over to Carl. Carl with a wrister, and that sliding block was made by Callahan. Around to the front, the horn sounds. The second period is over. Peace restored by smooth-talking officials. Coming up in the Discover Card intermission report, a performance by Late Night with Jimmy Fallon's house band and Philadelphia's own The Roots. Then a sneak peek of Cold War on Ice, which premieres on the NBC Sports Network immediately following our postgame. Plus, one of the survivors of that Cold War, Bobby Clark, will join Bob Costas and Mike Milbury in our studio. That's ahead on the Discover Card intermission report. 40 minutes have been played. The teams trudge off one more time. They will return once more and play a third period, perhaps a 5-minute sudden death overtime, and perhaps a shootout. Brian Boyle and Pierre.
Little scrum at the end of the game or at the end of that period. Is smash mouth hockey better suited for you guys?
Yeah, we want to play a hard-nosed game. It doesn't really, that stuff doesn't necessarily matter, but we want to play a hard physical game between the whistles. And if they want to give us some crap, we're not going to stand for it.
After you guys fell behind 2-0, what was the message on the Ranger bench?
We should get the next one, cut it in half, and we did that. We had some momentum there, and, we started playing a little bit better.
You're not used to getting double-shifted. I noticed in the second period you were double-shifted a couple times with John Tortorella. Was that because you, Dubinsky, and Callahan were going?
I hope so. I mean, we're trying to play well. We're trying to create some momentum and get on the forecheck and have the puck in their end as opposed to ours, but... it's a back-and-forth game. They're a skilled team, and, we all go when our number's called.
Thanks for your time, Brian.
Thanks, Pierre.
The well-spoken middle child from a family of 13, Brian Boyle. Coming up, Bob Costas, Mike Milbury standing by to bring you the Discover Card intermission report. After 2, Flyers 2, Rangers 1. No carryover penalties nor power plays as the third period begins in this one-goal game. You got a chance to see your old teammate, Jaromir Jagr?
Yeah, with our great vantage point about 20 feet from the Flyer bench while Pierre was doing his interview with Brian Boyle, I had a chance to grab Jagr really quick as he was about to skate off the ice and just ask him how he was doing after only having 2 shifts in that second period, and then 8 seconds of ice time, and just kind of looked at me and just said, didn't say anything, but just had that face, that look on his face of not good. So it'd be interesting to see if he gets any ice time here in the third period. But just him being on the bench in the situation. But Jaromir Jagr, a couple of real good shifts in that first period. Here, one of his last shifts of the first period. Talking to the medical staff of the Philadelphia Flyers, and they're leaving before the end of the first period, coming back, only having 2 shifts and still on the bench here for the majority of that second period. Now to start the third period, so something to keep an eye on.
Puck shot out of play at the Flyers bench. We won't guess, but there seemed to be a little pointing going on as Jagr left the signal to the bench. We don't know if that was the general area of the problem, but at any rate.
And again, the bench he is sitting on is very warm. Pierre, you had a chance to sit on those benches to stay warm in the intermission. It might be the best place in the building for Jaromir Jagr if he is body sore anywhere to keep that heat on him, because those benches are keeping the players nice and warm when they're on the bench.
Well, it's interesting. We saw the Rangers finish the second period with Boyle, Dubinsky, and Callahan. Now John Tortorella playing another hunch. Brad Richards with Dubinsky and Callahan. Richards has had kind of a tough afternoon. I think you would agree, Edzo. This is an opportunity for him to play with 2 energetic guys.
Not a lot going on for Richards, but he doesn't need much to get involved and create one chance.
Careful block aside by Lundqvist. Shots in the game are 26-17, the Flyers. Shots that would be goals. 2 of them have been for the Flyers and 1 for the Rangers here in the third. Lifted along by Kimmo Tiimonen and played back by Jake Voracek.
It was a good play by Tiimonen because he had Richards right on his backside. as this game has gone on, the puck has really been bouncing a lot more than it was early in this game.
Here's Shen with a shot that's deflected up out of play.
Boy, right on the foul line. It's hit the fair foul pole at 329 feet from home plate here at Citizens Bank.
Which way did it go? Was it a good one or not?
Oh, it was fair. It was fair.
What an atmosphere. This is just spectacular here.
Not far from where a couple of long ones near Ashburn Alley were sent by Ryan Howard.
Got another ice
Chase
issue.
Utley's hit a few this way.
He has, yes. Saturday, don't miss a wild card doubleheader on NBC. Game one, the Bengals take on the Texans. Then in primetime, the Lions take on Drew Brees and the Saints. Bob Costas hosts Football Night in America live from New Orleans at 4 Eastern, 1 Pacific.
Lots of scoring coming in that last game.
Oh, yes. Darren Pang.
Well, thanks very much. I was told from the New York Rangers locker room at the end of the second period, when Scott Hartnell went up to Mike Rupp at center ice, took him aside, and he said to him, show some respect. Jaromir Jagr's a Hall of Famer. I found that pretty interesting, and that should heat things up here in this period and see if Hartnell gets an opportunity to take a piece of Mike Rupp. I think Mike Rupp was just having a little bit of fun with it. I told one of the New York Rangers, pretty interesting that a non-goal scoring player was actually able to have the calmness to take off the glove and actually do that.
Like Doc said, he scored a Stanley Cup winning goal, so he's got a little experience scoring some big goals.
Conversation there between Hartnell and Fedotenko. As this is rattled along for Ruslan Fedotenko, pushed it on, hoping for Haglin, no luck there. Played on by Boyle, but it ricocheted back, and so he has to retreat further. Spun up the boards off the stick of Giroux. Brought back on by Haglin, crosses and backhands one that is fought off, and then the rebound stopped by Brizgalov as well.
A beautiful shot there by Carl Haglin after the good play by Boyle just to get the puck to the middle of the ice.
And Riemsdyk with this one. Jersey born forward for the Flyers, rolled that one along. It's Hartnell to take it there, back up the boards. Giroux rattled back around behind now, and Van Riemsdyk, the surrogate Jagr. Since the early stages of the second period, sees this one go loose off of Girardi, and then coming by with a vengeance was Hartnell. No icing on this. Play will continue. We had a little bit of snow. I don't notice any just now. Poked right back along. It's great cosmetic snow, courtesy of Jim Cantore and Goff. Meanwhile, this is back on now to be played further by Bourdon. And across for the carry back up by Couturier. First-year player rolled it in and went back after it. Couturier run into there by Delzato. Jabbed around to the front. Moving on in was Carl, ripped one that is fought off by Lundqvist. In his skirmish, the Rangers able to emerge and play it back on. Good thump put into Mitchell, but they move ahead. Here's Rupp with it. Rupp with a shot. He scores!
Well, Doc, you saw him do it in New Jersey. Now he's done it here in the Winter Classic. Two goals for Mike Rupp. The former Erie Otter, a little burst of speed.
Nice pass there by Brandon Prust on the backhand. And I thought Mike Rupp had a chance to shoot this puck right away. We have a perfect vantage point. And Bobrovsky down, not a good goal to give up by Bobrovsky on that short side. But Mike Rupp waited, and his puck finds in between the arm and the hip of Sergei Bobrovsky. Down, but not down early enough. He absorbed that in the chest. Not a good goal, but a good opportunity there for Rupp to just get the puck to the net.
Dubinsky led it ahead. Callahan popped one loose. It went off of Tiemannin. Worked along now by Hartnell, who starts it on. Hoping to get a 3-on-2. Leads one that Van Riemsdyk will chase down. Ryan McDonough closed him off, but he outreached him and pitched it on over to Hartnell. Now Giroux. Giroux fed it back. Coburn with it there. Fires! And that one grabbed and held by Lundqvist in a pile. So many players around. Does he still have it? Whistle is blown. Doesn't matter.
Yeah, it was Van Riemsdyk that got pushed in behind. from behind by Ryan McDonough. There's Van Riemsdyk in front of the net. A little bit of a push off. It's like almost like in a game of basketball, a subtle little push off when that shot goes up to the rim, looking to create some space. Nice job there by Van Riemsdyk, and a good stop by Henrik Lundqvist.
Eddie, we just saw another line combination from the Flyers. Van Riemsdyk going with his old running mate, Claude Giroux. We saw them in the Stanley Cup Finals 2 years ago, Philadelphia, Chicago, do such a great job. They played tremendously well last year. Yager came here, and Van Riemsdyk became forgotten. In the second period, it was Voracek there. Now we're seeing Laviolette go with Van Riemsdyk.
You have to go to a lot of different looks because the Flyers down to 11-4. Yager still on the bench, not playing hardly at all in that second period. You're going to see a lot of different looks. And you mentioned, Pierre, the change for John Tortorella in that second period. We'll just get that feel and that pulse of what's going on, trying to get the right combinations out.
Simmons with a heavy hit coming from Delzato. Spun to the back, Carl Bordona shot, and that one knocked down. A throw to the front by Simmons would not work. Hard work comes from Reed. Then along to Carl. Deflected behind. Matt Reed bodied off. Now Simmons. Hard work on the boards, but then Delzato is able to lead across, and Stu Bickel can charge ahead. Fired off the stick of Gavrik. Gavrik had that one lost in traffic. Fielded back out. Rangers in the midst of a change. Mark Stahl arrives and plays it on to Stepan. And then to Anisimov. Trailer is Gavrik. Anisimov backhander. Save Bobrovsky. Rebound. And it popped around behind. Bordone stripped of the puck by Gavrik. Gavrik defended by Mazaros. Up the boards it comes. Claude Giroux filtered it through. Hartnell able to lug it ahead. The big man up the wing. Hartnell to the outside. Trigger pull with lockdown. Oh, and he sent Bickel hard to the corner boards. Drop down on goal, no icing, and it's given to McDonough. Rangers get it back to center. Drop back in by Dubinsky. Lilia run into by Dubinsky. Van Riemsdyk watching there as Richards was on him. Back down, it is sent, and this time there will be an icing. Inside the glass, Pierre.
Mike Ruff's become a story this Winter Classic. He's already scored a Stanley Cup winning goal. He had a fight last year in the Winter Classic. And here's an example of what Mike Ruff can bring with the Pittsburgh Penguins, fighting John Erskine at Heinz Field. And then this year, Brandon Press right into the wheelhouse for Mike Ruff, scores the first one and then a second one from a bad angle. Bad goal, but a good goal from Michael Ruff. And we're all tied up.
Prust and Mitchell with assists on both goals. And Mike Ruff. So the marquee guys are not the ones who have connected. But there's a try by Dubinsky. Rebound, score! Richards has broken the tie!
Eddie and Doc, I got to tell you, John Tortorella deserves an assist on this. He's been manipulating the lines. Richards wasn't great. But Enzo, you called it on Richards. He doesn't need a lot of time.
Well, Ryan Callahan with a great pass in behind the net. Face-off win, use the area in behind the net. Dan Girardi with the play down low. Callahan with a low look and a beautiful play there by Brandon Dubinsky to get the puck off to the side where Brad Richards is standing. Claude Giroux in behind, kind of in between a no man's land. And no chance for Bobrovsky.
That's a vintage play by Brad Richards, who won a Stanley Cup down in Tampa. That's a rolling puck. He elevates a rolling puck at a key time. And look at the reaction by Marion Gabbert and our team Anisimov. But I really believe John Tortorella, when he started manipulating his lines in the second period, changed the chemistry of this game. And now Laviolette's trying to get his guys refocused, re-energized, and playing to their strengths.
Yeah, calling a timeout, trying to stop the momentum of the Rangers.
What a great coaching battle. Laviolette and Tortorella, both products of the U.S. college hockey system. Laviolette played at Westfield State. Tortorella played at Salem State and University of Maine and Orono. Just phenomenal coaches, both of them.
So back in it comes, and Strawman rattles it around. Directed back out by Prust. The guys who got the first two goals for the Rangers are out there right now. Mitchell and Prust and Ruff, but ahead with this comes Max Talbot. Talbot chased down and jostled by Delzano. Half-boards played safely back in and corralled by Voracek. Run into by Prest, guided it ahead, and Mitchell is able to nudge it to center. Rupp came by to get that one, could not finesse it through, and then carried it and an offside. A goal by Richards, two by Mike Rupp, one with a salute, one with none.
Eddie, what would you do if you're Peter Laviolette right now?
Well, I think that you shorten your bench. I think you get your big guys on the ice a little bit more, that being Claude Giroux, Scotty Hartnell. I think Wayne Simmonds has had a real strong game. I like that line, Pierre, of Talbot, Giroux, and Hartnell. And I think you got to continue to try to get your defensemen involved, not only offensively when the puck is down there, but jumping into the play through the middle of the ice to try to create some odd man situations. Lots of time if you're the Flyers, and I like the time out there by Laviolette to really slow this game down.
Good work by Fedotenko to the back. Bickle a shot, and that ricocheted back out. Mark Stahl able to chop it along, and eventually we get a stoppage of play. Mike Rupp with two, and Brad Richards celebrates the tiebreaker right now. Here, well behind home plate, let's take a look at the Ford update in this game. Braden Schenn, first career goal.
How about that? Winter Classic scores his first goal. Congratulations to Braden Schenn. Big Mike Rupp, one coming in. Only played 14 games to this point. He's got his second and third. A big goal by Brad Richards. They give the Rangers a 3-2 lead. 13 and a half minutes left to go in the third period.
Focus shifts to center, where the Rangers are able to control from this faceoff. And Matt Carl shifts from defense to offense with a pass that escapes all the way back down. And icing. Defensive side of the center end line over the end line and touched by the opposition. So the faceoff to come back near Bobrovsky. The gravity of the drama come to players? Do they know how dramatic this game is when they're in the midst of it?
Not necessarily in the midst of it, Doc, but when you are sitting on the bench or, you know, there's a TV timeout, I mean, that's when your mind wanders. It's hard not to, especially in the venue. But once you hop over those boards, I mean, the focus is one thing, and now you'll see the stakes go up just like on the ponds right across the U.S. when you go out and play with your friends or your teams out on that ice. When the games are close, as it gets later, the intensity goes right up.
Wayne Simmonds has been strong offensively in this game and generating chances for his team, 17 in orange, and he battles the half boards.
He's just sized really good along the boards and won a lot of battles, as he just did on the near boards there on the Rangers.
Looks for Coburn. Reaching in Couturier. Coburn has it. But it is Strawman, run into by Danny Briere. Off a flyer stick across to Coburn, a shot, and that one out of the glove of Lundqvist. Another centering pass, and back across it comes yet again for Tiemann. Rattled around behind, Briere with it there, trying to tuck it in front, no luck, goes down on the play. Back up and battles along. Scrappy play, and it's sent off of Simmonds, and Strawman took the hit and then rolled it back down.
A good shift here for the Flyers. First one in a long time, sustaining a little pressure. Not a lot going on. The shot by Braden Coburn, but they won a lot of battles along the boards. Were able to hold on to that puck and create some offense. And now it looks like John Tortorella is going to use his timeout. Each team gets one timeout per game, and a long, long shift for the guys on the ice. And John Tortorella decides that it's time to give the guys a little bit of a breather.
Almost 8 minutes into this period before the Flyers get their first chance. The Rangers with a pair from Mike Rupp.
Beautiful pass there by Brandon Prust. They're making a 2-1 game, a little bit of a salute. And then Mike Rupp again, short side on Sergei Bobrovsky to tie it up at two. And then Brad Richards off the play from Ryan Callahan and Brandon Dubinsky. Give the Rangers a one-goal lead here in the third.
What's interesting here, Eddie and Doc, is Derek Stepan usually is a center. It's a right-hand shot. It's an easier play for him to take this draw. But I think they're going to use Anisimov, who's a left-hand shot. It's a tougher play for him to get the puck back in the corner, isn't it, Eddie?
Yeah, and Giroux's going to try to win this puck right to Van Riemsdyk get behind him. Nice job there by Anisimov to tie up the stick of Claude Giroux.
Reaching in Hartnell. Punch back on near Gabrick.
kept alive by Coburn. And Delzano for the Rangers. Anisimov reached in yet again. Taken to the outside and ripped on back now to Timonen, but a pass that was so strong that it ricocheted off him and he must play at center. Here's Giroux yet again, but that one is blocked. Rushed right back on by Gavrik, drops off to Dubinsky. Brandon Dubinsky led it on a cross, drive! And that one blocked down by Timonen and shaken up on the play. Game trooper, he coasts over to the bench and is replaced by Carl and by Mazaros. That defensive tandem has been changed for the Flyers here as this one is blocked along and eventually sent to the back. McDonough shot! And that one forced off on the rebound by Carl. Another drive! Oh, off Bobrovsky and just wide!
Very similar to the shot that Mike Rupp took and caught in the jersey of Bobrovsky on that one. He got lucky. The shot from Girardi.
That one was from Callahan. A scare for the Flyers and their fans here as this one goes back where Girardi is after it. Voracek up with it in traffic. Lost though, and Girardi got out of the way of some of the hit that was coming.
Well, Maxime Talbot went crazily into those boards. He was going to make the hit on Girardi. It looked like Girardi had lost an edge, and Talbot went in very dangerously into those boards.
Rattled back around by McDonough. Taken by Ruff. Forced back down. Lilia going to get it, no icing this time. Rattled all the way around again. And Talbot was given a good thump that time by Girardi. Angled back in and Lilia turns with it now. Trust and Ruff and Mitchell are back out for the Rangers. Lobbed ahead now and on with it into the corner with Simmons. Worked over there by Mark Stahl. Simmons again turning with it. Oh, and then sent flying was a flyer. That time it was Simmons by Trust. Led to the back. Lilia shot! And it's covered by Lundqvist.
We talked about the physical play between the Flyers and the Rangers this afternoon. Here's Brandon Prust with Wayne Simmons. A little bit of push from behind. Right in the center of the back. No chance for Simmons to stay on his feet. And then there's the Maxime Talbot going in on Dan Girardi.
Just goes airborne, Edzo. He just tries to explode right into Girardi. And anytime you drop a game plan to play the Rangers, guys that play 26 minutes or more like Danny Girardi does, usually they're a target. But Maxime Talbot fearlessly trying to launch himself into Danny Girardi.
We're going to have another ice delay just inside the blue line of the New York Rangers. You know, there's a difference between being, you know, you got to work smart, you got to hit smart. You can't run out of position to make those big hits because it takes you out of position and give up opportunities.
The resumption of the game in a moment. Welcome back to the Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic from Philadelphia. Rangers fans here believe their team has come from 2-0 down to lead 3-2, but still 10:01 to go in the third.
Flyers, after the timeout by Peter Laviolette, started to hold the play down in front of Henrik Lundqvist. A couple of good chances, not outstanding chances. They picked up their game since the coach's timeout.
John Tortorella just then during the TV timeout told every one of his players up and down the bench, every single guy here blocks shots. Nobody takes shortcuts.
Haglund's shot is held by Bobrovsky.
Well, it feels a little differently when you block shots outside.
I think John Tortorella's coached a magnificent game here this afternoon. He's had his finger on the pulse of the team the whole time. They didn't get off to a great start. Henrik Lundqvist was huge for him, Edzo and Doc. And then when he started to reel it in, you could see he started giving the right guys the right amount of ice time.
Yeah, he's shortened his bench.
Again, Bobrovsky with the catch. Both of these coaches raised in New England. Both of them played outside. John Tortorella near where the Concord Bridge is in Massachusetts. Peter Laviolette in Norwood, Massachusetts.
up till 10 o'clock, and then his grandfather shut off the lights. He had the convenience store next door. He had to sleep and be there at work in the morning. You guys are done. Played back along now to Derek Stepan. Stepan able to pivot back. Watch there. Stride for stride by Kimmo Tiimonen, who was injured by that shot earlier, but you're not going to keep him off the ice. Ripped back down and can be played by McDonough. Sailed back down, and Tiimonen pursued there by Stepan, and so Bobrovsky slugs it ahead. That one's squipped away from Hartnell. Lob back across, though, and Van Riemsdyk looks for some help.
All right.
Stoppage of play. Ruslan Fedotenko said, I grew up in a big city in Russia. We never played outdoors unless we were going to Switzerland. Every game we had in Switzerland was outdoors. Number 26 in white you saw there as we look on at this rink on a chilly evening in Philadelphia, the 2nd of January, 2012. We hope it's been a wonderful holiday season for you, and what a way to cap it off with this. Two teams that have played each other for 45 years. Going hammer and tong into the third period with 8:50 to go, another icing.
And if you're the Rangers, you have the lead. You want to make sure that the blue lines become so important that the puck's got to get out of the defensive zone and the puck's got to get in deep at the Flyer blue line so you don't give up any odd man situations.
Darren Pang.
Well, the one concern would be the shadows at this particular point. But I talked to Marty Biron at the end of the period, and he said it's not unlike Madison Square Garden, who's got the most shadows in the NHL, has for many years. So he said it's really been no problem, and he talked to Hank about that.
Marty Biron, former Flyer goaltender, now the backup, had a terrific year as the backup goaltender for Henrik Lundqvist and the Rangers.
A fantastic teammate, so supportive all the time.
Here is Dubinsky, but there is Van Riemsdyk. Some would argue Madison Square Garden has some ghosts, too. Cranked back in, off a glass. Rolled back up the boards, and it is Mitchell punching one behind, and Rupp going in after that, but Coburn prevailing, getting it back up now to Hartnell. The big winger flies one back across. Voracek couldn't come up with that. Circling back is Rupp, and he pitched it back in past the leaping form of Coburn to the corner. The two big men go. No icing here as Lundqvist stops. 7:40 to go, third period. 31 shots to 29 in favor of the Flyers. But on the big board, it's 3-2 thanks to the goal by Brad Richards. Braden Schenn brings it on. He got the first one of the afternoon. It was light out then. This period began in darkness. Bobrovsky out to handle. Shoved it back up the boards and away from the reach of Hagelin. Delzato connected back across. Strawman played it off the stick of Fedotenko again. Bobrovsky gets a second chance at this one and pushed it off of Fedotenko. Fed out in front just off Hagelin. Drive by Girardi is blocked down by Bobrovsky. Rebound and unable to get a shot away was Brian Boyle. All close calls there in the Flyer end, but Bobrovsky was able to make the play. Now Hagelin ripped one, and that ricocheted off Bobrovsky. Another shot, he stopped that one, and the rebound poked to the corner. All Rangers right now. It is Boyle turning with it. Boyle to the outside, angles it on back. Girardi a drive, and that one was saved by Bobrovsky again.
Boy, Girardi's had about four shots on this shift directed towards Sergei Bobrovsky. Outstanding shift for the Rangers.
Directed back in by Hagelin. Obedient change in lines for the Rangers. Flyers doing the same thing. They get Matt Reed back out there. Danny Briere trying to get it to him in a lot of traffic. Can't do it just yet. But in the safety of center, it's ripped back in.
And in a big collision at the blue line, Marion Gaborik and Danny Briere.
Two of the marquee guys with a hit. Strawman connects with Delzato. Third period shots are 15-5 in favor of the Rangers. Laid on back again. Bordone tried to work ahead. Up with it now is Simmons. Too far for the play by Danny Briere, and so it's just sent back down again. Bobrovsky out to assert himself yet again. That one bunted on by Reed, but now picked up and started back by Strawman. Wanted to shake his way by. but the puck went first, and it's on to Bordone's stick. He's able to lob it back ahead for the Flyers. Matt Reed trying to pick his way to center, and does. And the pass up the wing, and Van Riemsdyk charges after this one. Stroman able to get there defensively on him. Van Riemsdyk reverses it along. Ricochet back to be taken further by Timonen, played behind. It is Giroux trying to bank one in front, and we get a stoppage of play, and a penalty is coming up. Rangers are steamed about this. It'll be a Flyers power play when we come back.
There's Ryan McDonough. The puck is in behind the net. Watch what happens to him. James Van Riemsdyk is going to eventually push Ryan McDonough into the net, not allowing him to go and get to Claude Giroux. And they called a delay of game penalty against Ryan McDonough. Not the right call in that situation. No doubt Van Riemsdyk was the reason why the net came off.
Power play sponsored by Verizon 4G. Voracek gave it across. Timonen worked it further. Giroux with it there. Roughed up a bit on the boards. It's neatly kicked along to Prest and scaled back out. Girardi and Prest together on that penalty kill for the shorthanded Rangers. To the last 4:50 of regulation time. If tied, overtime. If tied after 5 minutes of sudden death, it will be a shootout. If it remains the same in the last minute, you'll notice a Flyers goalie pull, and they'll go with six attackers. But let's see. Timonen handing across. Fires one, and that one was blocked away by Boyle. Scale back up the half boards, held there by Giroux. Giroux fed one at the front. Mark Stahl defending there on Vic Hartnell. Timonen tries to connect on with Giroux. Second effort, Giroux able to circle and then rip one across that was just onside. Fed on across near Voracek and fired by Van Riemsdyk. Glove down in front by Girardi and slipped back onto center.
Oh, big time play there by Girardi because Scotty Hartnell was in behind all alone in front with Henrik Lundqvist.
Timonen filtered it on back. Carried ahead by Matt Carl to the last 48 seconds of the penalty kill for the Rangers. Carl blasts the heart around. Closed off was Reed. Reed able to get that one, but then just that quickly taken on by Dubinsky. Moving up there with Ryan Callahan, forced it back in. Callahan going in. Saw that one cycled on back defensively and worked there for Mazaros. No shots on this power play yet. 3:35 to go in the third period. Briere fires it back in hard. Rattled on around and Carl burrowed in after it. Thrown around and grabbed by Briere. Circles and he's got Mazaros at the point. What'll he do? Got it back to him for the shot. Deflected in front. On it. Rattled on around off the post. Then to the outside. Again, we get a whistle and stoppage of play. We cannot tell in the skirmish. Perhaps the net was dislodged or the referee lost sight of it.
Right part of your screen. Right there off the side of the post by Matt Reed and the redirect. And the puck is clearly free.
Ian Walsh is the official there. You see him by the left post of Henrik Lundqvist. He comes in and he loses sight of that puck.
Oh, the Philadelphia native Ian Walsh. There's the opportunity for Matt Reed. You see the waving of the arms by the official. With the puck clearly free. Great break for the Rangers. Bad one for the Flyers.
It is at the point that he does not see it any longer that the decision is made to blow the whistle. And even though that might occur later, it is a factor in deciding that the puck is frozen.
Mark Stahl's on the ice for the second time during this penalty kill because Ryan McDonough's in the box. Stahl's first game since the start of the year. He hasn't played, and now he has a big clear.
Big faceoff win there by Brian Boyle. So important. Winning those faceoffs dictate exactly what happens all over the ice.
Rangers have killed it off. Timonen able to move away from Stepan. Rifled it back in as we're down to the last 3 minutes of regulation time.
Remember, both teams have used their timeouts.
Max Talbot defended there by Girardi, who poked it along but into some traffic. Two aside continue this work. Rangers get it out to center. Striding on ahead with it, moving on over as Gabrick wedged off, though he got a short side shot off that was stopped by Bobrovsky. It looked like the Timonen had him played pretty well, but he still got a shot away.
Yeah, he did, and I think it might have been been skate-aided, Doc. Look at the speed, the acceleration of Marin Gaber. Kimmo Tiimonen comes in over on the left-hand side, and yeah, it was the right skate that got that opportunity. That puck ends up in the back of net. I don't think there's any doubt there would have been no goal.
You surprised there was no penalty against Tiimonen in there, Edzo?
Yeah, a little bit right at the end. Tell you, you call that penalty on McDonough down there?
Yeah.
I'd agree with you.
Mazaros to Carl, crisply on to Giroux, nudged on across for Voracek. Voracek tried to lead it further, stepping up to it, Mazaros. Rammed there by Ryan Callahan. Fed out in front, unable to get a shot away, Hartman. Turnaround shot by Mazaros, and that rattled off the glass.
The referees are letting him play.
What a way to finish, if this is the finish. Or the prelude to continuation to the last 2:10. It is Carl. Carl threw one, and that one shrugged away by Lundqvist, and play is stopped as he's able to grab.
Well, looks like Giroux is down on the ice.
Boyle got a stick up into his midsection. Giroux went down, and Scotty Hartnell stepped in.
Pierre, we always ask you about the conversation down at the ice. I know you've heard a number of languages today, foreign and domestic.
Yeah, there's been a lot of animosity between these two teams, both physically and verbally. And there's a stick. Watch Big Boyle come in. There's a shot by Carl, and Henrik Lundqvist with a save. The carryover, there's a stick into the midsection. Giroux goes down.
If you're the Rangers, you got to be aware, a defenseman jumping in into play. Matt Carl, a defenseman jumping in on that last opportunity. If you're a winger in the Ranger zone, you better have your head on a swivel, understanding where the defensemen are for the Flyers. Anything goes, you get to this juncture in a game. Look for D to be pinching in. Look for them to try to create and sustain a little bit more offense. They'll cheat in a little bit more from the blue line, just to keep plays alive.
Eddie, at what point does the goalie pull take place?
I got to say that once you sustain a little bit more pressure, it's probably a little bit too early. But I would have to think that once you get into that minute and 5 minute and 10 range, if you're Peter Laviolette and the Flyers, you get Sergei Bobrovsky to the bench and get that extra attacker out there.
From the tie-up, it is carried back along by Fedotenko and backhanded out. Colburn able to drop it ahead, and that one comes back down where Strawman must play for the Rangers' defense. It is McDonough back up the board. Up for grab, but taken by the Rangers, and lobbed back along by Strawman. Quickly, Tiimonen. Follow up, McDonough. And again back in, and Bobrovsky will let this one go to Colburn. Under 90 to go, third period. Haglund jabbed it free, but back up the boards can be played as far as center. And then lobbed on now for Hartnell. And coming to the bench, Bobrovsky for the extra attacker as Hartnell knocks down Girardi. Six attackers for the Flyers trying to tie it up here. Stepping free is Giroux, but a block there. And the net is empty. Ryan Callahan trickles it back down. Haglund coming, taken out of the play was Callahan.
Matching minors, Doc. They're going to get Callahan and Tiimonen. Callahan for embellishment and Tiimonen for a hook. Ian Walsh makes the call.
With the net empty, both teams lose a man.
Now here comes Kimmo Tiimonen.
44, Philadelphia, minor penalty.
And he gets the stick up around Rangers the arms of Ryan Callahan, and you see the legs go out, and right away, Ian Walsh, he points at both players.
It's a stick hold on Callahan.
And pretty definitive, Ian Walsh, a Philadelphia native, played for the little Philadelphia Flyers. Was a leading penalty minute holder for that amateur program.
Presumably knows fouls when he sees them. 1:06 to go. Ryan Boyle won that one cleanly, but it was so clean that they ruled it unfair.
And this could play to the advantage of the Flyers because it's 4-on-4 hockey here. As soon as the Flyers get control, Peter Laviolette will get Bobrovsky off the ice. It'll become a 5-on-4, a power play opportunity. I almost like that situation better than the 6-on-5. Just so many more bodies on the ice. Obviously, an advantage here, Flyers.
Bobrovsky charges toward the bench again. Extra attacker is out. Puck is loose. Diving play, and it's worked on now. Got it on to Briere, sent back to Voracek. Holds now. Voracek with a shot jammed out at the front of the net. Cleared back down the ice. Taking it well short of the end line, and danger is Carl. 38 to go. Through the traffic, it is brought back in by Danny Briere. Briere rolled it to the corner, went right after it. Girardi able to outman him there, but it's led on back to the point. Held there by Carl, sped back to the outside. Drew laid it across. Voracek, a shot, fall off by Lundqvist. Big scramble there. And the whistle is blown.
Beautiful pass there by Claude Giroux all the way across over to Jake Voracek. And you got Briere Hartnell looking for any opportunity. Watch Ryan McDonough come right into the crease. Going to come right into your vantage point right there. Boy, and very close to Ryan McDonough, Pierre, putting that hand over that puck in the crease.
No question. That would have been a penalty shot.
Absolutely.
Look at that scramble.
Look at that puck just barely under the pad of Henrik Lundqvist. If they called a penalty shot?
Well, you had all the evidence that you might need for one.
But I couldn't clearly see if Ryan McDonough put his hand on that puck. You could slap it out, but you cannot close your hand on it. It is a penalty shot. Boy, I could not see from that vantage point that he put his hand on the puck in the crease.
Danny Briere on the ice at the time will take it. In post-game shootouts, he's 20 for 45. Anywhere close to 50% is tremendous. Briere against Lundqvist. Save Lundqvist! With 19.6 to go.
Well, Briere picks up this puck, head up all the way, Lundqvist out, tries to go between the legs in the reaction from Henrik Lundqvist. Briere had his mind made up the whole way.
Lundqvist has been an amazing story all afternoon into this early evening for the New York Rangers.
Still time for the Flyers. Big faceoff here.
Net is empty. Extra attacker for the Flyers. Off the tie-up. It's punched on across. Carl with it there. Sidesteps one, but it's broken up. Kept on back, though, and ripped on across now for Voracek. Voracek fired it wide of the cage. Moving on is Giroux. Collision with him. Covering up is Carl. Shot blocked by Girardi. Another try by Voracek. And that one popped high. 1 second to go. And the Rangers have won it. What a finish. Final minute, goalie pulled, penalty shot awarded, stopped. More around the front of the net as the horn sounded. We see zeros on the clock. The Rangers gather around Henrik Lundqvist to celebrate the 2 points in the standings for the first place team in the Eastern Conference, the New York Rangers.
Down two, three straight goals. Contributions from fourth line guys like Mike Rupp, Brandon Prust, John Mitchell, and a game-winning goal by the big free agent in the summertime, Brad Richards.
The winning goaltender, Henrik Lundqvist, with Pierre.
Of all the things you've done in your career, especially winning gold in 2006, where does this measure up?
This was amazing. From the get-go, already coming in yesterday, practicing, and great atmosphere. You know, you talked about going into this game and finding a good balance. You know, you want to be focused and do your job, but at the same time, you want to be able to enjoy it. And it's that's a tough thing, but it was great.
It was never easy for your team, especially when you're down 2-0. Did you think, I better not let in another goal?
Yeah, you know, they came hard there for 5-10 minutes, and when they score the second one, you can just feel that the next one's going to be huge. So Rupper scored some big goals for us there. We came back at it, and just a great game for us. And then I hope the fans enjoyed it.
Thanks for your time, and enjoy tonight.
Thank you very much.
Doc?
35 shots by the Flyers, 33 stops by Henrik Lundqvist in the victory. There was a combined total of 68 shots on goal today. The NHL Foundation is contributing $13,600 to Ronald McDonald House Charities. And the 2012 Honda Pilot, valued at approximately $41,630, goes to the Ronald McDonald House in New York. For the NHL Foundation and Honda, the biggest assist happens off the ice. ...60 eventful minutes. 3-2 Rangers, Bob Costas.
All right, Doc, and a final aerial shot. Always such arresting images from the Winter Classic. The Rangers down 2-0, come back to win it 3-2. It's the fourth time in five Winter Classics that the road team has won it. Only the Bruins in 2010 managed to win at home at Fenway Park. All right, that'll do it for now from Philadelphia. The NFL playoffs begin Saturday with a wild card doubleheader on NBC. In game one, the Bengals take on the Texans. Then in primetime, the Lions face off against Drew Brees and the Saints. Football Night in America begins live from New Orleans at 4 Eastern, 1 Pacific. And a reminder, coming up immediately on the new NBC Sports Network, it's the premiere of Cold War on Ice, the story of the summit series between Canada and the Soviet Union in 1972. 8 games of intense, even brutal hockey featuring some of the game's great players and unforgettable characters. The Cold War on Ice is next on the NBC Sports Network. Once again, the final score here in Philadelphia. The Rangers win it over the Flyers 3-2. And for now, so long, everybody. Continue.